Very good morning everyone and welcome to today's market commentary. On daily time frame, Nifty opened gap up above yesterday's close and it took resistance near the closing price of this large red candle. So these are the levels which we had marked earlier, and the new line that you can see in today's market commentary would be this blue line. So what is there? This is a trend line resistance that is marked from the previous high, the highest high made by Nifty this year, that is from 11,171 to the high of this bearish candle, which was formed on 2nd of May. So connecting high of this candle with high of this candle and extending it towards right gave us this trend line resistance. So today, there is a confluence of resistance. One is this trend line resistance and the other one is the closing price of this red candle. So not only the closing price here, this was the common price for this candle also. So that price level is having a higher significance and the price was 10,760. So exactly at that point, Nifty opened gap up today. And that was the high made today. So open is equal to high. So that is a bearish candle. One thing which we were saying from many sessions earlier in our market commentary sessions was, so Nifty is bullish and it took a small retracement near the support zone. Now, as said, it took a bounce back from this support level, open gap up. And even today also it tried to continue the bullishness, and in that euphoria most of the participants have put the orders even before the market has opened. So it should be either after market orders or orders in the pre-open session. So this euphoria led Nifty to open gap up today, and people who were already bullish, they are trying to book their profits. So that is leading for the downfall in Nifty. So at some point of time, this should get settled down and we should see a U-turn again. Now, yes, the levels that we had mentioned yesterday were 10,785 for Nifty to be long-term bullish. So that we are definitely aware of. Only for the short-term bullishness, we are seeing the behavior of the candle. But for the long-term bullishness, it is bullish. Nifty is bullish. Only above 10,785. But in between this, what is the price movement that is being made by Nifty? What is the price level that is acting as resistance to Nifty? Those things we are trying to analyze now. And based on our analysis, trend line resistance as well as the closing price of this candle, both in confluence together are acting as a strong resistance to Nifty. And what is acting as a strong support? The high made, there was a prior gap down here, and the high made by this candle as well as the common price level of both these candles. So all these things combined, that is acting as a strong support to Nifty here. So what is the price level? That is around 10,702, and the low made today till now is 10,707. So it did not yet come to that price level, but even if it comes there, that should act as a strong support to Nifty. So we are now clear about why Nifty is facing a resistance and what is the next level of support for Nifty. So if Nifty breaks even this level, so we are very clear that 10,640 should be our next level of support for Nifty. So on daily time frame, these are the price levels that we can see. So pivot points, it is still trading in the mid zone. So no need of seeing that. Even Bollinger Bands also, once it took resistance near the upper channel where we drew this open is equal to high candle, there was a trend line resistance. So that point is a very important or a crucial point now, 10,785. So once Nifty closes about 10,785, we can straight away see 10,940 on cards. RSI is still trading above 60, so that is a sign of bullishness. So on daily time frame, this is the main observation that we could find on Nifty. So let's move down to further lower time frame, which is hourly time frame. So hourly time frame, a clear resistance is seen here. Now we need to enable the pivot points and see what is the story there. So on pivot points, it opened above R1. So yesterday, as expected, it came down, took support near the prior support level, that is 10,640, and made a very good bullish movement until 10,720. Now today it opened gap at around 40 points above, and it is now coming down. So on hourly chart, hourly time frame, it is closing below this R1. So this R1 was our resistance for yesterday, and it could not surpass that. So today it tried to open gap up above that, but it is not able to sustain. So if this continues, if it is not able to sustain above R1 for the next hour also, then we could again see a good downfall in Nifty. But in that moment, 10,700 is again there for us. It will come as rescue for Nifty. So that will definitely act as a good support, 10,700. So even though Nifty is falling down now, 10,700 should act as a strong support. If that is taken out, then definitely 10,670 can be seen easily. So on hourly, only pivot points we have seen now. So a channel expansion was possible if this was a green candle. Now since this is a red candle, and if more red candles follow after that, then definitely this is a mean reversion, and mean reversion can happen until central pivot point of this week. So since this is a hourly time frame, pivot points will be valid for a week, and if at all mean reversion happens, then definitely this 20 period moving average will be touched by Nifty. So that price level is around 10,660. So mostly two indicators are telling us something on hourly time frame. So on daily time frame, the picture is clear. Now on hourly time frame, price is not able to sustain above R1. So it tried to expand the channel, but now it is closing below R1. If further more red candles are followed after this red candle, then mean reversion can happen until either the central pivot point or 20 period moving average. So that is the visible conclusion on Nifty based on hourly time frame. Rest, RSI is not saying anything. It is still trading above 60. So that is definitely a sign of bullishness. So going to further lower time frame, which is 15 minute. So even on 15 minute, RSI is not showing any clear picture. This R1 acted as a strong resistance and pushed down the price. So what is acting as support? That is the prior resistance level, which is around 10,700. So this 10,700 is acting as support. If I draw another line here, so if you see, all these candles are having high price in common. So that price is nothing but 10,707. So today, the support taken is exactly at that price level, 10,707. So in intraday time frame also, for Nifty, 10,707 to 702 is a very strong support level. And below that, we also have this 10,690, where there is a central pivot point and 20 period moving average. So both these things combined should act as a strong support for Nifty. So overall combined, 10,707 to 10,690 will act as a strong support for Nifty on 15 minute time frame. So these are the only things visible on Nifty. Now let's move to our other index, which is Bank Nifty. So Bank Nifty, we already drew our resistance levels as we did for Nifty. So even here also, yesterday when we saw this resistance line getting broken, we anticipated that once Bank Nifty closes above 25,820, then easily 26,100 can be achieved. So if you see the high attained today, 26,088. So around 22 rupees of difference is there. So around 12 rupees of difference is there. That's it. So rest, it has already achieved it, its first target. So now if it manages to close above this, again it has a resistance in form of 26,366. So that is the low made by this candle. So although it is facing a rejection at some point of time during this expiry, it should definitely try to move at least until 26,230. So from 25,820 until 26,220, it is around 400 points of movement that can be seen in Bank Nifty. So already yesterday it gave us a good movement until 25,920. And now the next target that we are assuming is 26,220. So this is just a profit booking happening now. So it had opened gap up. Yesterday's closing price was 25,852. And today's opening price is 26,074. That is around 200 points of gap up was seen in Bank Nifty. So definitely there can be a profit booking be seen in Bank Nifty because it has approached earlier resistance. So people are afraid and they want to book their profits early because this should be a first target for many traders. So that is the reason most of the profit booking is seen here. So since Bank Nifty is falling, it is also dragging Nifty further down. But it should settle down. This prior resistance should now become a support. So even if Bank Nifty comes down, 25,820 should act as a very strong support to Bank Nifty. So when that takes 25,820 as its support, again, we can see a good bullish movement in Bank Nifty. So pivot points is what is acting as a strong resistance to Bank Nifty. On daily time frame, the open and high price are exactly near the R1 of this month. And R1 is also in confluence with prior resistance. So both these things combined, that is acting as a very strong resistance to Bank Nifty. Next is Bollinger Bands. When we activate that, yesterday itself we had a channel expansion. So whatever the resistance that Bank Nifty is facing now, it should get settled down at some point of time. And again, there should be a U-turn possible in Bank Nifty. RSI is also not showing any clear picture, but it is trading above 60. So that is a sign of bullishness. So going to lower time frame. So here if we enable our pivot points, we have R3 in form of resistance. So at 26,100, we have R3 for this week. So that is acting as a strong resistance here. On daily time frame, we have R1. And on hourly time frame, we have R3. So natural resistance in confluence with R1 of daily and R3 of hourly time frame. All these three things combined, that is acting as a very strong resistance to Bank Nifty. So when it comes down, As said earlier on daily time frame, 25820 should act as a strong support, and even before that we have 25860 as R2. So both these things combined, that should act as a strong support. Not only that, the gap up opening which we had, so the closing price of this candle as well as high price of this candle should also act as a strong support for Bank Nifty. So there's no need to panic that Bank Nifty is coming down. Only if it breaks all these three important support levels, then Bank Nifty is bearish. Otherwise, if it forms a very good base here, either near the closing price of this candle or near R2 or near 25820, if it forms a good base here and if it takes a U-turn, then one will have a very good risk to reward ratio trade. So then definitely one can take new positions in Bank Nifty. So as of now, only thing happening is the profit booking, because it is approaching the prior resistance, the important resistance zone. Many traders are getting out of Bank Nifty, because if one had taken position just at the closing price of yesterday, today we have a 200 point of gap up opening. So closing price was 25895 and opening price is 26074. So that is around very much near to 200 point. So those 200 points, some traders are trying to book their profit. So even in early time frame, we have this channel expansion. Now we need to see if this support gets broken, then that should be a mean reversion. Or if this resistance is broken, then that definitely should be a channel expansion. So on 15 minute time frame, what is the story? So even though Bank Nifty opened gap up, there is no bearish divergence. So from here to here, it is not possible to see there. So that will not have much significance, because in between we have many tops. So all our conclusion on Bank Nifty should be that 25820. See here, even on intraday time frame, we have R1 at 25950. So that is first level of support. And at 25820, we again have the central pivot point, natural support and central pivot point. So conclusion for Bank Nifty would be 26100, which was the first target for us, that is almost reached, but 26220 is our final target for Bank Nifty for this expiry, because 25820 was our entry price and 26220, around 400 points, was our target for this month. So that should definitely be seen by the end of this expiry. And on downside, 25820 should again act as a strong support for Bank Nifty. So that is what clearly visible to us. So if you all have any stocks to be seen, you can just put it in the chat box and we'll go through them. So first stock is Z Entertainment. Mostly it is moving in sideways and currently the stock is very volatile. So definitely if it moves up, 620 should be our target. And on downside, let's try to draw some trend line supports here. So this is the trend line support that is clearly visible, and there seems to be a trend line resistance also here. So, and this is the trend line resistance for Z Entertainment, trend line support as well as trend line resistance. So once this gets broken, 603, then the first target should be 610. So this is the first target. Here we have a gap down opening, so that should be the entry price 603, and above we have open is equal to high here, so 610 it should be our first target. And even if this is crossed, then definitely 620 is our next target in Z Entertainment. Now if it comes down, this trend line should again act as a strong support for Z Entertainment. And if we enable our pivot points as well, so yes, 603 is definitely a very, very strong resistance for Z Entertainment, and that is the reason we had a price rejection from that point. There was a natural resistance and there is also trend line resistance. Thirdly, there is R1 of this month. Now if you see our target also, it definitely coincides with the pivot point R2. So let Z Entertainment close above this 603.5, or to be precise 604, and then you can aim for 610 as your first target and 620 as your second target. Next is Vedanta. So even in Vedanta Limited, long term we have already marked the support, trend line support, and long term trend line resistance is also present here. Let's go to lower time frame and see. So this was the lower time frame which I had marked earlier. So this is the trend line resistance. When the high of this candle and high of this candle are connected and extended further, today's opening candle, that is early candle, it faced a very stiff resistance here and it closed below trend line support as well. So if I just move it further down, connecting all the lows perfectly, so you can see that there is a very good close below this trend line. Now even if it goes up, so that trend line resistance should be there. So prior trend line support now should act as a trend line resistance to Vedanta Limited. And pivot points, it is trading below central pivot point, so then definitely that is a bearish sign, but we still need to wait and see if it manages to close above this or not, because the early candle is not yet completed. So we need to wait and see until 11:15 if this candle manages to close above this or if it comes below. So trading above in between doesn't matter. So it can go there and by the end of the hour it can again come down and close below this trend line support. So it is better to wait for the closing price of this candle. And in further lower time frame, so even here also we have our closing, and even here also it is trading below central pivot point. So even if it comes above, then definitely the central pivot point will once again act as a strong resistance. So one can again enter shorts here, keeping this as their stop loss, high made by today as their stop loss, or the trend line resistance as their stop loss. So long term and short term views are clear in Vedanta. Now we shall move to TVS Motors. So for TVS Motors, this is the long term support. Earlier it acted as resistance, and going forward that acted as a very strong support. So the price level is around 607, and from there it took a bounce back, opened gap up yesterday, and even today there is a very small gap up. It is trying to trade above S1. So that is the only thing visible to us based on pivot points. And even in Bollinger Bands also, although this red candle closed below lower channel, again there is a mean reversion happening. So we expect TVS Motors to reach at least 643 on first hand, and if it closes above, then central pivot point should easily be reached by TVS Motors. So all that needs to be observed is whether today's candle will sustain above yesterday's high or not. So yesterday's high is our decision level for us, so that is around 630, and today the candle should close above 630. If it closes and sustains above 630, then definitely 643 should be on the cards, and above 643 central pivot point should be reached by TVS Motors. Next is L&T. Even here we have a trend line support. Let me just adjust my screen first. So this is the trend line support acting in L&T, and 1380 level is the resistance level for L&T. So only this candle is showing that 1380. So as of now it is trading below that. So even if it is trading below that, price is trading above central pivot point and above 20 period moving average. So if I zoom in a bit, so this brown line here it is, so that is 20 period moving average, so that is trading above both of them, central pivot as well as 20 period. So price is still in bullish zone, and this trend line should act as a very strong support for L&T. But yes, this is definitely a very narrow range that is being traded, and if you see, Bollinger bands are approaching towards each other, so it is forming a narrow range here. When Bollinger band channels approach towards each other, that means volatility is less in this particular stock. And whenever there is lesser volatility in any stock, then definitely a ground for higher volatility is getting prepared. So you should be ready to take position in L&T, and the decision level should be 1400. So when 1400 gets surpassed, so your first target is 1415, and even if that level gets broken, so higher highs can be seen in L&T. So trend line support and Bollinger Band's mid band, central pivot point. These three things are acting as strong support for L&T, but it is not correct time to enter into L&T as of now. So it's better to wait until 400 price gets breached. Even Havells also trading above central pivot point as well as 20 period moving average, and it is at the support zone. The low made by today itself, which is 546, is a very strong support to Havells. So it is bullish only above 555. Why? Because we have very important resistance levels here. Not even 555, it is bullish only above 557. So let us mark that clearly here. Havells is bullish only above 557. So if it does that, then channel expansion will be there. Even here, the width between Bollinger band upper channel and lower channel is very less when you compare with this width. So here the width is very less. So a ground is being prepared for a larger movement that can be either on the upper side or on the lower side. But if it goes in the upside direction, then 557 should be the a decision level for Havells. Next is ICICI. Now ICICI opened gap up above the very strong resistance of 295. So yesterday that was results day. So yesterday it could not make a very big up move, but definitely traded in the strong positive zone. So price traded above the central pivot point and it also traded above 20 period moving average. So based on that, it was positive. And the rectangle which we drew here, that and as well as this 295 price acted as a very strong resistance for ICICI. And now it is going above the second level of resistance, which is around 307.35. So here both these candles and as well as this long Marubozu, red Marubozu, which has its open is equal to high. So this important price level is now getting breached. So the next target for ICICI should definitely be 315. And why 315? Because that is R2 of this month, as well as there is a prior gap down opening here at the same price. And prior to this gap down, that is a very strong support zone. Here it acted as a strong support and here it acted as a strong resistance. So 315 should be on the cards for ICICI Bank if it closes above 307.35 today. So these are the stocks and indices for today. Thank you all for joining.